Welcome to Tea with Erping. Are you one of those people like myself who get excited at the end of every meal in a Chinese restaurant, knowing that you will get a fortune cookie? It has become quite a tradition to have your last cup of tea accompanied by the crumbling of a fortune cookie with a word of wisdom on a tiny piece of paper. Let me entertain you with some interesting facts about these unique but delightful cookies. First, what is a fortune cookie? A crisp, sugary, vanilla-flavored cookie with a message written on the paper inside. The message on the paper can include Chinese proverbs, words of wisdom, and lucky lottery numbers. Although served as a dessert in Chinese restaurants all across the United States and Canada, this cookie did not originate from China. The same goes with the popular dish chop suey, another American invention as well. The exact origin of this fortune cookie is not clear. Some Asian immigrants in California claim to have popularized it in the early 20th century. Dating far back in the 19th century, similar shaped cookies with a paper fortune placed in the band of the cookies were already found in Kyoto, Japan. They were made of sesame and miso and are called Zujiro Senbei. Zujiro is a Japanese kind of fortune telling. Zuji means intersection. And the Japanese tales believe that an intersection is not only where humans cross, but also where gods convene, and that a bridge is a border to a different world. These fortune tellers would stand by the intersection or under the bridge to tell fortunes of random passers-by. The cookie with the fortune paper inside is connected to the Japanese shrine tradition of getting fortunes told, or omikuji fortunes written on strips of paper. Makoto Hajiwara of Japanese Tea Garden in the Golden Gate Park of San Francisco is reportedly the first person in the US to have served the modern version of the cookie in the 1890s or the early 1900s. The fortune cookies were made by a San Francisco bakery, Ban Kyodo. Around World War II, fortune cookies were known as fortune tea cakes, reflecting their origins in Japanese tea cakes. So, how did fortune cookies migrate from Japanese bakeries to Chinese restaurants? Well, food preferences likely played a part. Japanese emigrants to the United States around the turn of the 20th century found it difficult to open Japanese restaurants because Americans generally did not fancy eating raw fish back then. Therefore, in many cases, the Japanese migrants ended up opening a Chinese restaurant because Chinese food such as chow mein, fried rice, and deep-fried spring rolls were more suited to the nation's palate. These Chinese restaurants needed something for dessert, and the fortune cookies were a low-cost and easy solution to satisfy their customers. These cookies also gave an air of an exotic culture from faraway land, filled with wisdom, which is greatly appreciated in Western society. A great marketing strategy, I must admit. Another theory for why this happened is due to the Japanese-American internment during World War II, which forcibly put over 100,000 Japanese-Americans in internment camps, including those who had produced fortune cookies. This allowed Chinese manufacturers to take over the growing market of this particular cookie. In 1992, the Wonton Food Factory attempted to expand its fortune cookie business into China, but gave up after fortune cookies were considered too American. This should come as no surprise, as the Communist Revolution in China has shaped the nation to automatically discard the least of any ancient wisdom. Those beautiful Chinese phrases of wise words, greatly appreciated by other countries, do not quite fit into the Communist Party's mindset of no tradition needed. Currently, 3 billion fortune cookies are made each year around the world, with the vast majority of consumption catering to the North America market. The fortune cookies you have at a restaurant now are made in a very similar way to how the traditional handmade ones were made. The ingredients typically made with a base of flour, sugar, vanilla, and sesame seed oil are mixed in a large tank and squirted onto fast-moving trays. The dough would then be heated in a sort of conveyor belt and then compressed with round, hot plates. The cookies are baked for a minute or so and are then reshaped by molds. They can be mechanically shaped or molded by hand. When automated, a machine folds the cookie into the right orientation with the folding paper inside. Cooled and hardened cookies are sealed in plastic wrappers, inspected, and ready for sale. Fortune cookies became so well known that around 1988, they made their way into marketing campaigns of companies such as Motorola, FedEx, Apple, Google, Twitter, and many more. Kevin is the second generation owner of the Golden Gate Fortune Cookie Factory located in San Francisco, Chinatown, which was opened in 1962. He hopes to pass on the traditional fortune cookies for as long as he can, and even thought about turning his factory into a museum. With the never-ending fortune the cookies have been receiving, it does seem like a terrific idea to keep this tradition going. Then what are the typical messages in the cookies? They are usually made of an aphorism or a vague prophecy, and often come with some lottery numbers. Here are some sample messages in the fortune cookies. He who throws dirt is losing ground. Change is inevitable, except for vending machines. Do not mistake temptation for opportunity. A cynic is only a frustrated optimist. A conclusion is simply the place where you get tired of thinking. The fortune you seek is in another cookie. And that cookie, my friend, is this one, with wisdom from Confucius. Tradition reflects and shapes people's values and beliefs, providing cultural identity and integrity. Preserving them through generations is important and requires our part to safeguard it. Worldwide, all nations put in a significant effort to preserve their cultural values and historical relics. Whenever I stand before the huge, impressive Buddhist frescoes at the Metropolitan Museum in New York City, I would have mixed feelings about them. A Chinese historian told me that he would be sad to see them here. But had these frescoes not moved here, they, along with the Buddhist temple, would have been burned down like many others during the Cultural Revolution, and we wouldn't be able to appreciate them today. Unfortunately, in China, cultural and spiritual genocide are still taking place these days. Just look at what has happened to some of the historical sites, such as Confucius Hall, and the ruthless persecution of Falun Gong adherents, Tibetans, and the underground Christians. As Mahatma Gandhi pointed out, a nation's culture resides in the hearts and in the soul of its people. Boethius, author of The Consolation of Philosophy, said, "All fortune is good fortune, for it either rewards, disciplines, amends, and punishes, and so is either useful or just." Hence this story of fortune cookies. And I'm fortunate today to be drinking a cup of freshly brewed green tea. Until next time, may fortune and peace be with you, and tea be by your side.